Now, sa video natin ngayon, ito naman yung sasagutan natin. Now, for the purpose of saving time, gagamitan na lang natin ng Microsoft Excel para mas madali nating ma-solve yung end moments. But makikita nyo lang din naman kung ano yung values sa columns natin. And then, yung ma-recommend ko is using the modified method, try to use 8 cycles. Malapit na yan sa actual answer talaga. And then, yung ituturo ko is how to deal with overhangs. Diba, nasali yan sa lecture natin, but how can we apply it sa actual na beam na talaga? So, ito yung approach natin. So, here we have to calculate the support reactions using the modified method. So, ibig sabihin yung end rollers or hinge ends, imamultiply natin yung stiffness nila by 3 over 4. So, yan yung consideration natin dito. And so, dinivide ko na yung beam according to the FEM. So, we have span BC, span CD, and span DE. So, meron tayong tatlong FEM na mako-compute. However, notice na yung AB is naka-overhang siya. Now, ito yung mayayari dyan. Whatever I hear is, it won't matter. If this is 2i, 3i, it won't affect the support reactions of the beam. Kasi nga, naka-overhang yan. All we have to do is to transfer the load and then also transmit the moment that it will cause. So, essentially, what we can form here is parang beam na yung 20 kN nalagay na sa point B. And then, lagay na lang natin din yung moment na na-cause niya. So, bale, ito yung mangyayari. Remove natin yung overhang. Tapos, ilagay natin yung 20 kN load sa point na to. So, 20 kN. Now, ano yung rotation na mako-cause ng load na to sa point B? Diba, it will cause a counterclockwise rotation. Therefore, we also have to include a moment here which is equal to 60 kN. Now, 60 kN since 20 multiplied by a distance of 3. Diba, yan yung moment na mako-cause niya. Therefore, our new beam would look like this. Ayan. Ito na lang. Bale, tinanggal na natin yung overhang and then we are just dealing with span B up to E. So, you can neglect AB or the overhang. So, kaya yung FEM natin, itong tatlo lang. So, copy ko na lang to and then lagay ko sa ilalim. Now, for span BC, we have a loading of 12 kN. Ayan. And then, yung length natin is 4 meters. Diba? However, we also have to add this load. Now, itong WS squared over 30, this is for the triangular load alone. Therefore, yung FEM natin, meron pa tayong i-add. Kasi merong ma-add na loadings. Diba, yung 20 kN, malalagay na yan dito. So, 20 kN. Green yung external loadings caused by this load na nasa overhang. And then, 60 kN acting counterclockwise. So, lagyan din natin ng load na counterclockwise. So, 60 kN. Now, diba, sa first lecture, nabanggit ko na if you have a concentrated moment na directly applied over the support, diba, itong 60 kN nasa fixed support yan at the left. Yung mangyayari is, wala nang reaction dyan dito. Bale, this load won't cause a fixed end moment sa kabilang side. So, yung magre-react lang would be the fixed support mismo. So, kapag 60 kN yan, counterclockwise, the fixed end moment would be clockwise na to counteract the direction. So, merong madadagdag na fixed end moment, kulayan natin ng yellow, and then we have another fixed end moment, yan, which is clockwise na yung direction. Yan. Since ito, counterclockwise, clockwise yung fixed end moment. So, this would be the value of M. Now, ano yung M? M is the applied moment dito sa support mismo, so 60. Ayan. So, di ba, we can compute two FEMs, FEMBC and FEMCB. So, for FEMBC, we would have WS squared over 30. This is counterclockwise, so minus. And then, may ma-add pa, which is 60 kilonewton meter. So, plus M. Na bakit plus? Again, this is acting on a clockwise direction. Ayan, plus. So, we would have the load is 12, so minus 12. And the length is 4 divided by 30 plus M. So, yung M natin, 60. Positive. So, input natin sa calculators natin. We have minus 12 times 4 squared divided by 30, then plus 60. So, we would have 53.6 kilonewton meter. Now, you might be wondering, how about yung 20 kilonewton na load, sir? Wala ba siyang makukos na fixed end moment? Tingnan natin yung formula niya. Ito yung formula para sa load P applied anywhere sa span. Now, notice A is the distance from the left patungo sa point of application ng load. Now, kapag yung load natin, load P natin is nandito talaga sa fixed end or nakasagad sa fixed end, notice that A would be equal to 0. Diba? And then, if A is equal to 0, what would happen sa fixed end moments? Magsi-0 lang din. Kasi kapag 0 yan, you're essentially multiplying by 0 and then ito rin. Kapag 0 yan, 0 yung fixed end moment. So, ibig sabihin pala, walang FEM na makukos yung 20 kilonewton load. But ilalagay natin siya dyan para sa pag-solve natin ng reactions. Para sa beam talaga. So, ito na yung fixed end moment natin para sa BC. And then, for FEM CB naman, ito, sa kabila, CB, we would have WS squared over 20, then clockwise, so positive. Ayan. So, equals 12 times 4 squared. Divide natin yan by 20. So, remove na lang natin to, yung 60. And also, the negative sign. And then, the denominator is 20. So, we have 9.6 kilonewton meter. Ayan. Now, how about this load? Again, yung 60 kilonewton meter, since nasa fixed support yan siya in-apply, walang reaction dito caused by this one. Kaya yung FEM natin would only be caused by the triangular load lang. So, yan yung dapat mong tandaan. And then, sa kabila naman tayo for span CD. For span CD, we have a load of 6 kilonewton meter distributed. And then, our span is 6 meters. Ayan. Therefore, our FEM, diba, equal lang yung FEM CD saka FEM DC. Since symmetrical lang yung loading natin. However, the sign would be opposite. Dito, negative. Sa kabila naman is positive. So, FEM CD is negative. W is 6. And then, L is 6. So, 6 times 6 squared divided by 12. And then, sa kabila naman, we have FEM DC. So, equal yan to WS squared over 12 lang din. So, copy ko na lang to. And then, input natin sa calculator, we would have negative 6 times 6 squared divided by 12. So, negative 18 kilonewton meter. And so, it would follow na sa kabilang side, for FEM DC, this would be positive 18. Ayan. So, dito naman tayo sa span DE. Now, for span DE, we have a 45 kilonewton load applied 2 meters from D. So, ibig sabihin, yung A natin becomes 2 meters, and then B is 3 meters. Tapos, yung P natin is 45. And then, L would be 5 meters. Yung total ng dalawa. A plus B. Therefore, our FEM, FEMDE, would be PAB squared over L squared. So, 45 times A, which is 2, and then multiplied by B, which is 3. So, 3 squared, then divide natin by 5 squared. And then, FEM ED from E, this would be PBA squared over L squared. So, 45 times, alternate mo lang to, 3 times 2 squared na. Tapos, divided by L squared, 5 squared. So, we have here 45 times 2 times 3 squared divided by 25. This is 32.4. And then, negative pala to, considering the direction, counterclockwise. So, minus 32.4. This is KNM. And then, yung kabila naman is, palitan mo lang to, 3 saka 2. And then, we have 21.6. So, meron na tayong values para sa FEM. Now, yung kulang na lang would be the values for DF, or the distribution factors. So, we can solve it right here. Now, di ba, KBC would be equal to KCB para sa span na to. And then, our relative K, or stiffness, is di ba, I over L. Now, our I is 2I, and then divided by L, which is 4. Ayan. However, you have to take note na we have to apply the modified method. Now, for the modified method to work, then you have to multiply the stiffness by 3 over 4. So, 3 over 4. Now, bakit nga minultiply natin yan by 3 over 4? We multiplied by 3 over 4 since this is now a hinged end. Now, kapag meron kang end na naka-hinge, then you can apply the modified method and then you will not carry over na sa side na to. So, again, although na meron siyang overhang initially, tinanggal na kasi natin siya and then we transferred the loads. So, this will now act as a hinged end. So, kaya multiply by 3 over 4. So, ito yung medyo bago sa problem na to. And then, for the next one, we have KCD equals KDC para sa span na to. So, we have I over L pa rin, 4I divided by 6. Ayan. And then, sa kabila naman, for DE, we have KDE equals KED, which is 3I divided by the length, which is 5. So, 3i over 5. So, now, pwede na natin i-calculate yung ano natin, DF, distribution factor. Yan yung importante talaga para sa table. So, copy ko na lang ulit yung beam natin. Ayan. So, dito sa joint B, we would only have one value of DF. Since, isang adjacent member lang yung meron. But sa joint C, we would have two distribution factors. So, one for CB and another one for CD. CB saka CD. Ayan. And then for D naman, we have two adjacent spans, DC and DE. So, dalawa pa rin. Copy na lang natin. And then for joint E, we only have one adjacent member. So isa lang din. Ayan. So ito na yung distribution factors natin. And then let's label this as DF. And then sa bottom side naman, we have our FEM, which stands for fixed end moments. So first, isosolve muna natin yung DF. Now yung DF ng B, since this is a hinged end, nasa pinakadulo yan na hinge, then this would be 1. Ayan. Then for joint E, we have a fixed support, so our DF would be 0. Diba? Ito yung first natin na masosolve talaga. Kasi hindi yan kailangan ng numerical values using K over summation of K. Meron kasi tayong rules para dyan. Now, yung makukompute natin would be DFCB, DFCD, saka DFDC, and DFDE. So, ano yung DF? Diba, formula for DF is K divided by the summation of K. So, if you are to compute DFCB for this side, then we would have KCB divided by KCB plus KCD. Bakit KCB plus KCD? Kasi sa joint C, yung connected are CB and CD. Yan always yung magiging denominator mo. Kung ano yung connected sa joints. So we would have here, KCB is 2i times 3 over 4. This would be equal to 3i divided by 8. So 3i over 8. Tapos divide natin by KCB, which is 3i over 8 pa rin, plus KCD, which is 4i over 6. So input natin sa calculators natin. 3 over 8. Then divided by 3 over 8 plus 4 over 6. So we would have 9 over 25. Ayan. And so it would follow na yung DFCD natin, this would be 1 minus 9 over 25. Ito yung shortcut. But if gusto mo yung solution, then I can just write it. So, this would be DFCD. So, ito, papalitan mo lang yan ng KCD. Bale, ito yung solution by variable. This will now be KCD. Ayan. And then, KCD is 4i over 6. So, palitan mo lang to. So, if this is 4i over 6, 4 over 6, we would have 16 over 25. Which is again, it can be obtained using this one. So, 1 minus 9 over 25 equal yan to 16 over 25. Since, dapat kasi, kapag same joint, let's say joint C, yung total ng dalawang DF must be equal to 1. So always remember that concept. So here we have 9 over 25. Then sa kabila naman is 16 over 25. And then dito naman tayo sa DC saka DE. So we have DF of sa DC muna tayo. Ayan. So KDC is 4i over 6. Then divide natin by the summation of K sa total connected members. So DC and DE. So 4i over 6 plus 3i over 5. So input na lang natin. We have 4 over 6 divided by 4 over 6 plus 3 over 5. So, magiging 10 over 19. And so, yung DF diin natin, palitan mo lang yung 4i over 6 by 3i over 5. Kasi sa DE na tayo. Yan, DE. So, kailangan yung numerator sa DE rin. So, 3i over 5. Ayan. So, magiging 9 over 19. So, input na lang natin. 10 over 19 and 9 over 19. So, this would act as DFED. Ito naman yung DFBC. Yan. So, sulat na natin yung FEM, which would correspond pa rin sa same labeling. Now, yung FEM natin for B is this one. 53.6 BC. FEM BC. Ayan. Then, for CB, 9.6 kilonewton meter. Then sa, ano naman, CD, we have negative 18. Then next, we have positive 18. And then sa side na to, we have negative 32.4 and 21.6. Ayan. Now, diba, yung next natin gagawin is to form rows para sa unbalanced moments and carryover moments. So, we would have here UM and COM, carryover moments. Move ko na lang to. Ayan. So, UM saka COM. Now, you can copy this one kung ilang cycles yung kailangan mo. Yan. But again, I will just use Microsoft Excel para sa remaining cycles. And so, our first unbalanced moment, this would be FEM times the negative of DF. So, 53.6 times negative 1, this would be negative 53.6. Diba? And then, dito sa joint C, meron tayong dalawang adjacent spans. So, we would have to add the two fixed end moments. Therefore, to calculate the unbalanced moment, we would have 9.6, this FEM, then minus 18, then times negative of DF. So, for this one, times 9 over 25, negative, which would give us 3.024. Ayan. And then sa kabila naman, we have to use 16 over 25. So magiging 5.376. And then dito naman, this will become 18 minus 32.4 times negative DF. So, times negative 10 over 19 equals this one, 7.579 using 3 decimal places. And then, sa kabila is 9 over 19. So, we would have 6.821. And then dito, medyo obvious, since 21.6 times 0, magiging 0 lang din. So next, we can carry over the moments. But again, yung carry over moment natin dyan, abale, wag mo na itong i-carry over sa side na yan. Since this will now become 0. Kasi diba, 53.6 minus 53.6, that's already 0. And then, alam kasi natin na zero yung end moment dito since nasa left end siya. Nasa left end tapos hinge. So, automatic zero na yung moment dyan, alam na natin. Therefore, i-zero na natin lahat sa remaining columns. So what we have to do is carry over na lang natin to sa kabila, but wag ka na mag-carry over from this side patungo dyan. So bale, yung next carry over natin, paganyan lang. Wala nang paganyan. And then, this one, carry over mo to sa kabila, and then ito naman, sa kabila rin. Tapos ito, carry over, divide by 2 dyan, and then yung 0, carry over mo dito. So, yung values natin, sa first cycle, this would be 53, negative 53.6 divided by 2, we have negative 26.8, and then 7.579 divided by 2, we have 3.795, so 3.79 na lang. And then 5.376 divided by 2, this is 2.69. Tapos ito, magiging 0. Then 6.821 divided by 2 equals 3.41. Now, dito sa next unbalanced moment na cycle, treat this one as parang FEM mo, and then repeat the cycle. Bale, carry over ka na ulit. Now, for the purpose of reviewing the process na lang, let's just fill the table up to the second cycle. And then for the remaining cycles, I will just let Microsoft Excel do the work. So here, for the unbalanced moment, this will just be 0, and then add natin yung dalawa. So add both -26.8 plus 3.79, multiply natin sa negative ng DF. So -9/25. So this is 8.28. And then sa kabila naman, this would be 16. 16/25. So 14.73. And then dito naman, 2.69 na lang, kasi 2.69 plus 0, the same lang. So times agad by negative DF. So -10/19, this is -1.42. And then sa kabilang side, this is 9. So -1.27. Ayan. Tapos dito, magiging 0 ulit. So, carry over, paganyan. And then again, ito, wag mo nang i-carry over yan dyan. Kasi alam na natin 0 yan. Saka ito rin. So, 0 to. And then, 8.28 divided by 2. This is 4.14. While 14.73 divided by 2, we have 7.37. So again, to speed this up, you can just use x divided by 2 and then press calc to change the number. So we have here 1. So to speed this up, you can just input alpha x and then divided by 2, then just press calc if you will move to another number. So ito pala, 0, magiging 0 yan dyan, and then 14.73 divided by 2, just press calc and then input 14.73. So this would be 7.37. Ayan. The -1.27 divided by 2, calc ulit, -1.27, this will give us -0.64. Ayan. So do the same para sa remaining cycles until yung unbalanced moments natin would be approximately 0. Kapag nag-approach na siya to 0, you can stop the cycle and then add all the unbalanced moments and FEM And then add mo lahat. And then add mo lahat ng value sa column from FEM. Yan na yung magiging endmoments mo. So, repeat the process until you can get the endmoments. Ayan. So again, yung endmoments, sum yan ng lahat ng value sa column from FEM. So ngayon, gagamitan na lang natin ng Excel. So, pwede natin itong i-copy. Ayan. And then, paste na lang natin. So, we have to follow this. So, we have to follow this table. Now, we have here DF and the next FEM. Tapos, unbalanced moment, then carryover moment. Now, before solving pala, press Ctrl A and then right click. Click on Format Cells, then press Number. Tapos yung decimal places natin, para same sa application natin, use 5 decimal places. Ayan, 5 decimal places. And then, let's input the distribution factors. So we have here 1 and then 9 over 25. Input from left to right. Then 16 over 25, tapos 10 over 19, then we have 9 over 19, tapos sa pinakadulo is 0. Insert na lang tayo ng row, so this would be for, saan tayo nagsimula, diba sa BC, so this is BC, then CD, BC, CD, then DC, tapos DE. Now, ilagay natin yung kung ano yung orientation niya. Now, ilagay natin yung sa joint niya na label. So we have BC then CB. BC, CB, tapos CD saka DC. Then DE and ED. Ayan. Then yung FEM natin, 53.6 positive. And then 9.6 negative 18. Then we have positive 18 minus 32.4. And then 21.6. And now, diba sa unbalanced moments, we have to multiply FEM by the negative of DF. So times negative DF. Ayan. And then sa joint C, notice na merong CB saka CD. Common yung C. Now, that only means na merong dalawang adjacent spans. So, we would have to add 2 FEM. So, this one plus this one, and then multiply natin by the negative of the distribution factor. So, times negative of this one. Then, since naka-fix yan, fixed yung cell niya, press F4 so that we have a fixed cell reference. Enter. Saka ito rin pala, essentially this is also fixed, but hindi yan magmamatter since we are applying the modified method. And then here we have the same pa rin, ito pa rin, but our distribution factor would be nasa cell na to. So, this is D2. Diba? So, ito yung naka-fix. D2 na. And then, sa kabila naman, we have two connected joints sa D. Kaya, merong DC saka DE. So, we would have to add the two moments. and then multiply by the negative of df. So times negative of this one. Then kailangan naka-fix. So press F4. Enter. And then copy this one. Paste. Ito naman magiging itong cell na to. So press F4. Then enter. And then here we have 21.6, tapos divide natin. Tapos multiply natin by negative of df. Ayan. So kailangan naka-fix din 'yan pala. Now for the carryover moments, 'di ba? Hindi ka na magi-carry over dito sa ano mo? Hinged end. Sa hinged end. So this will now become 0. Input mo na lang 0. And then magki-carry over ka lang dito. So this divided by 2, and then ito naman equals this one divided by 2, then yung kabila is ito, then divided by 2, saka ito naman divided by 2, tapos ito divided by 2. So again, alternating lang yan. So meron na tayong unbalanced moment saka carryover moment. We can now highlight the two cells. We can now highlight the two rows since yan yung isa-subject natin to iteration. So drag down na lang after. Ayan. Now, medyo pangit yung pag-analyze ng Excel sa pattern. Diba, kailangan zero na lahat dito. But notice, ginawa niyang arithmetic. So meron kang negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, increasing. So gagawin mo na lang is just input 0. Ayan. And then ito na lang yung i-drag down mo. Para tama talaga yung sagot natin. Now kapag 0 na yan lahat, notice na yung values natin magzi-zero siya up to this point. Diba yung UM natin naging 0 na siya. But meron palang 0.00001. So mas accurate if we will use up to this one. But again ha, even if you are just using, let's say, 8 cycles, masasolve mo na rin yan. Wait lang, may mali pala ako dito. This must be negative 1.42 divided by 2. So minus 0.71. Ayan. So, nakaligtaan ko yan. Pasensya. And so, notice here na the same lang yung values. Diba? Up to the second cycle tayo. Now, here we have, bale, ito na yan. 8.28, 14.73, the negative 1.42, negative 1.27, 0. Then, sa last COM naman, we have minus 0.71, 7.37, saka minus 0.64. So, this checks out. Now, to get the end moments, we can sum up all the values sa columns na to. So, equals, ano na lang, drag mo na lang to, then press auto sum. Ayan. Now, bakit nagwan yan? Wait lang ha. Okay. Na-highlight ko pala yung df. Hindi yan kasali dapat. So, dapat from B3 lang. Ayan. And then, drag mo lang to sa kabila. So, ito na yung end moments natin. Actual end moments. Now, highlight na lang natin and then add tayo ng borders. So, copy, Ctrl-C, and then lagay natin dito. Then, paste as picture para ma-adjust natin yung size. Ayan, so ito na yung end moments natin. And then let's consult our original beam. So ito na yan. And then ito yung end moments natin. So we can now solve the reactions. Now we will start from left to right na lang. So start tayo sa span BC. Ayan. So this is B. Ito naman yung C. And then don't forget to add the loadings. na tinransmit natin. So this is 20 kilonewtons, tapos 60 kilonewton meter. Then we have a loading of 12 kilonewton per meter. And then our end moment for, diba this is parang BC, CB, then CD, DC, tapos DE and ED. So our end moment for BC is 0. So wala tayong end moment dyan. Now dito na lang sa kabilang side. So for CB, we have negative 4.85241. So this is negative, meaning acting counterclockwise siya. So pag ganyan yung orientation, minus 4.85241 kilonewton meter. So ito, sa point B, meron tayong reaction at B. So this is BY, diba? And then sa point C naman, we also have another reaction. But take note, this will not be CY. Kasi yung point C natin connected to two adjacent spans, this one and this one. So meaning, this will just be CY left, or the left value of CY. Now, the span is 4 meters. So we can take moments about point C, set it to 0, and then we can solve BY. So BY times the moment arm, 4. Now this will cause a clockwise rotation about point C. And then we have 60 kilonewton meter acting counterclockwise. So that would be minus 60. And then 20 kilonewtons acting downward. So it will cause a counterclockwise rotation about C. So minus 20 times 4. And then we have the resultant of the triangle, which would be the area of the triangle. So 1/2 times base multiplied by the height. And then its moment arm going to C would be 1/3 of 4. Kasi patungo tayo sa matabang side ng triangle. So counterclockwise pa rin yung rotation. 1/2 times 4 times 12 times 4 over 3. And then don't forget na isali mo pa yung end moment. Now this is acting counterclockwise, so minus 4.85241 kilonewton meter na yan. Wag mo nang i-multiply yan by a moment arm. So set this one to 0, and then we can now solve BY. So x times 4 minus 60, then minus 20 times 4 minus 1/2 times 4 times 12 times 4/3, then minus 4.85241. Now set mo yan to 0, we would have BY equal to 44.213 1025. Now sulat na lang natin ng lahat ng decimal places. Ayan. And then this is kilonewtons. So meron na tayong reaction at B. And then solve naman natin yung CY left. To solve that, we can just sum up forces vertical. So we would have BY acting upward. So this value, and then minus 20 kilonewtons acting downward yan. Tapos minus this value, yung resultant ng triangular load. Remove pala natin to. Ayan. And then plus CY left equate to 0. Therefore, our CY left would be 20 plus resultant ng triangle, 0.5 times 4 times 12, then minus the reaction at B. which is 41.213 1025. So we have 2.78. CY left equals 2.78 68975. This is kilonewtons. So you have the option to store this one or wag na lang muna. Yung mas magandang i-store kasi would be the reaction at C na lang. Yung CY talaga. CY left pa kasi to. But you can store this one, since we are using our Canon calculator, we can store sa digits. So pwede ko siyang i-store sa 1. So shift store, lagay ko sa 1. Ayan. Para mas madali nating ma-solve yung remaining items. And then yung BY pala, pwede din natin i-store. So 41.213 1025, shift store, lagay natin sa B, since this is already BY. Ayan. And then sa kabilang span naman tayo, we have span CD. So for span CD, we have a loading of 6 kilonewton meter. And then our span is 6 meters. Tapos yung end moment natin is CD. So we would have this one clockwise, since positive. Bale, ito yan. 4.85241. Tapos sa kabila naman, we have 30.777, which is acting clockwise lang din, since positive. 30.77793. Sige, so we can now take moments about point D to solve CY right. Kasi diba, this would now be CY right, since nasa span CD na tayo. And then ito naman yung DY left. Ayan. DY left, kasi sa joint D, we have two adjacent spans. So this would now be CYR multiplied by 6, then plus 4.85241, then minus WS squared over 2 caused by the distributed load, minus 6 times 6 yung span natin, 6 squared divided by 2, then plus this value. Now, copy ko na lang to, and then change na lang natin yung color. Ayan. Now, set to 0, we can now solve CYR. So, we have here x times 6 plus 4.85241 minus 6 times 6 squared over 2 plus 30.77793 equate to 0, and then solving CY, we have 12.06. this is kilonewtons, and then we can store this sa number 2. Ayan. So lagyan natin ng label dito na nakastore siya sa 2. Therefore the reaction at C, CY would be 1 plus 2, kung ano yung nakastore sa variable 1 saka sa variable 2. Kasi CY left plus CY right. So recall 1 plus recall 2 equals shift store, lagay natin sa C. So this is 14.848 5075. This is kilonewtons. Ayan. So, nakastore yan sa letter C. And then, ito naman sa B. And then, to get DYL, we can sum up forces vertical. So, we would have CYR which is this one, nakastore sa 2. And then, minus the resultant of this load, so 6 times 6, plus dyl. Dy left equals 0. Therefore, our dy left would be recall 2, ayan, yung nakastore, then minus 6 times 6 plus dyl equals 0. Or pwede rin, directly solve mo na lang, make this negative and then make this positive. So, 23.93839 pala. This is Kn. And then, shift store, lagay natin sa 3. So, lagay natin ng label. Ayan. And then, for the last span, we have DE. So, DE yan. And then, our end moments are negative 30.7793. So, this value, but naka-counterclockwise na siya yung direction niya. Tapos, sa kabilang side, 22.41104. Positive, so clockwise. Ayan. And then, our loading is 45 kilonewtons. Applied 2 meters from the left. So, 2M saka 3M. So, we would have here dy right as our reaction. And then, sa kabilang side, this would be ey. So, moment tayo sa point E. We can solve dyr. Ayan. So, dyr, multiply natin by 5. Then, minus this one, 30.77793. Tapos, plus 22.41104. And then, minus 45. Counterclockwise kasi yung makukos na rotation ng load na to about point E. And then, our moment arm is 3 meters. Ayan. So, equate to 0. We have x times 5. Then, minus 30.77793. Plus 22.41 minus 45 multiplied by 3. So, solving dyr, we have 28.67. So, this is kilonewtons. Ayan. Ah, sorry. Wag mo palang i-box since hindi pa yan yung dy. Meron kasi tayong dy left. Now, yung dyl nakastore sa 3. So, ito store ko sa 4. So, shift store, lagay natin sa 4. Ayan. Therefore, dy would be yung nakastore sa 3 plus whatever is stored sa 4. So, recall 3 plus recall 4. So, we have 52.611768. And then, this is kilonewtons. And then, for EY naman, we can just sum up forces vertical. So, summation of forces vertical, we have dyr, which is this value, then minus 45, plus EY, and then equate to 0. So, EY would be 45 minus 28.673378. So, magiging 16.32. 16.326622 kilonewtons pa rin. Ayan. So, shift store, lagay natin sa E. Na wala pa lang naka-store sa C natin. I mean, sa D. So, para sa D, we have recoil 3 plus, again, recoil 4. Ito yung value ng DY. So, shift store, lagay sa D. Now, let's consider the whole structure. For the whole structure, we have the following reactions. Diba? So, kailangan, pag i-add natin lahat ng upward forces and all downward forces, kailangan mag-equal sila to zero. And then, we have to consider the signs. So, reaction at B plus reaction at C plus reaction at D plus yung reaction sa E. And then, minus natin lahat ng downward forces. So, minus 20, this one. Then, minus the resultant of this load. So, minus 1/2 times base na 4 times height na 12. Then, minus 6 times 6 resultant ng distributed load. Tapos, minus 45. Ayan. So, press equals. We have 0. So, tama lang yung values natin. And then, we can check naman, since na-model ko na to beforehand, check natin yung nasa app natin. By the way, yung moment reaction pala at E would be the end moment sa ED. So, this is naka kilonewton meter. Bale, yan na din yung reaction at E. So, clockwise yung end moment, clockwise din dito. So, ME equals 22.41104 kilonewton meter. Ayan. And then this would be BY, CY, DY, saka EY. Ayan. Na-open na lang natin. So we have this beam. Ayan. And we have the following reactions. So, 16.32662. Tama lang to. Then, 52.61177. Ayan. Now, ito, 14.848. May mali ba tayo? Teka lang ah. Ito dapat, 44.21. Then, this is 11. May 3 na discrepancy. Check ka natin. BY times 4 minus 60. Minus 20 times 4, then minus 1/2 times base times height times 4/3. Then minus 4.85. Type na natin ulit. X times 4 minus 60. Minus 20 times 4. Minus 0.5 times 4 times 12 times 4/3. Minus 4.85241. Equate to 0. We have 44.21310.25. Ah, okay. Baka nagkamali lang ako kanina. So, this must be 44 pala. So, yung CYL pala natin, it would be shift store. Ito dapat yung naka-store sa B. And then, we have recall B minus 20 minus 0.5 times 4 times 12 plus CYL. Equate to 0. So, dapat, negative pala. So, negative 0.213 1025. So this is what I meant, na pwede talagang maging negative yung left value ng isang reaction mo. So just consider the sign. Ibig sabihin yan, yung CYL natin is actually acting downward. So, lagyan na lang natin ng orientation dyan sa direction. So, shift store lagay natin sa naka-store yan sa 1. Now, yung CYR natin, hindi na yan affected sa kung ano yung nakuha natin sa BY. But our CY, in total, it will be affected since yung naka-store sa 1, ibang value na. So, just recall 1 and then plus recall 2. Ito na yung actual reaction talaga. So, bawas ka lang ng 3 dyan. 11.848 lang pala. Ayan. Sorry talaga. Nakaligtaan ko kasi yan. Anyway, I will not edit this out para alam nyo rin kung saan kayo dapat careful and then you can avoid the following mistakes. Diba? Yan naman talaga yung learning process talaga. The more you commit mistakes, the more you learn and then you can avoid it sa actual exams na. Lalo na sa major exams. So, take note, you have to be careful dyan. So, I believe tama na yung ano natin, reactions. So, 11.848 saka 44.213. Ayan. So, you might have noticed the mistake dito pa lang. But again, corrected na yan. Sige, so, ito na yung reactions natin. And then, just to prove na pwede talagang matransmit yung low dyan, bale, yung I dyan, let's say, gagamitan natin ng 4I. It will not affect the reactions. Notice, the same pa rin yung reactions natin. Ayan. So again, pwede mo yung tanggalin. And then yung loading sa overhang, you can place it here. So add tayo ng nodal point load, which is 20. Then add a moment load. This one. Click on the node. Then this is, ano yung moment na makukos niya, di ba? Counterclockwise. And then the value is 60. Ayan. Click on save. Notice na same pa rin yung reactions natin. Ayan. That's why kung meron kang overhang, just remove it and then transmit mo na lang yung loading. Yan talaga yung approach sa moment distribution method. So again, salamat sa pagkikinig. And then, pasensya na rin sa mga naging errors ko. But hopefully, meron kayong natutunan and then you can apply it sa exams nyo. Music.